Chapter 6, the header. Nephi is commanded to build a ship to cross the waters to the land of promise. Rebellion at sea. Their arrival in the promised land. 1. And it came to pass that Lehi and his family reached the great waters that separate the great lands that the Lord hath prepared for the inhabitants of the world, on which the sons and daughters of man reside. 2. And now it is expedient for me to explain that there were many things written by the hand of Nephi upon plates of ore pertaining to the struggles and sufferings of his father Lehi and his family in the wilderness. Nevertheless, the plates that I have made to abridge the record of Nephi are few, and therefore I cannot write even a small part of their experiences in the wilderness. 3. And it came to pass that Nephi was commanded to build a ship to take Lehi and his children, and also the children of Ishmael, across the many waters into the land of promise. 4. And it came to pass that once again Laman and Lemuel and one of the sons of Ishmael and some of the daughters of Ishmael began to mock Nephi, and they were desirous to return to the land of their inheritance. 5. And they were again desirous to take the life of Nephi and their father Lehi, and take their wives and their children and return to the land of Jerusalem. 6. And it came to pass that Zoram stood forth and took up a staff against the enemies of Nephi. For behold, Zoram was a great and loyal friend to Nephi, and the Spirit of the Lord was with him as it was with Nephi. 7. And Zoram fought with great strength and dexterity against Laman and Lemuel, and one of the sons of Ishmael, Bahanas not being present at the time. 8. And it came to pass that these enemies of Nephi were astounded and amazed at the strength of Zoram, who with the end of his staff defended every blow that they put forth against Nephi. 9. And it came to pass that Zoram struck down the son of Ishmael, and was about to strike down Laman and Lemuel. But Nephi stood forth, and embraced his friend, and begged for the safety of his brothers. 10. Behold, never hath one man been more dedicated as a friend than Zoram was to Nephi. And Nephi loved Zoram as his own brother, and he did also love Sam, who had also stood against his enemies for his protection. 11. And it came to pass that Nephi began to construct the ship according to the promptings of the Spirit. 12. And it came to pass that as the ship began to take form, even a most curious form that had never before been seen among men, Laman and Lemuel were exceedingly amazed, and gave up their plans to harm their brother, even so much that they did offer their hands to labor on its construction. 13. And when the ship was completed, they were struck with awe by the craftsmanship and preciseness of its construction, and they praised their younger brother for what he had accomplished. 14. And Lehi was pleased that his older sons were once again unified with Nephi, and he had great hope that the Lord would spare them from future wickedness. 15. But in this Lehi was sorely disappointed, for behold, his sons did once again rebel against their brother, and sought to take away his life after they had embarked on the great waters, and journeyed towards the promised land. 16. For it came to pass that they set out on the great waters, not knowing which way that they should go, having faith in the Lord that he would lead them safely to the land of promise. 17. And Nephi had constructed a platform that was affixed to the bow of the ship, and Nephi was commanded by the Spirit to place the compass thereon, and secure it that it might not be removed until they reached dry land again. 18. And Nephi did that which the Spirit had instructed him to do. 19. And it came to pass that once again Laman and Lemuel and one of the sons and some of the daughters of Ishmael rebelled against Lehi, and Nephi, and were desirous to kill him and take control of the ship. 20. And they did confine Sam and Barhanas and Zoram below the deck of the ship, so that they could not come to the aid of Nephi. And they bound Nephi and held him captive for many days. 21. And because of their wickedness, the compass stopped working. And it came to pass that the Lord caused an exceedingly great storm to rise up and threaten the destruction of the ship and all those on board. 22. And Laman and Lemuel were desirous to throw Nephi into the great waters, believing him to be the cause of all of their problems. 23. And it came to pass that as Laman and Lemuel were about to throw Nephi into the depths of the water, Lehi stood forth on the deck of the ship and held strong to the coat of his son Nephi. 24. And in a loud voice he cried through the fierce wind that he would not be a witness to the death of his beloved son, and that if Laman and Lemuel would throw Nephi into the depths of the great waters, then he also would go with him. 25. And it came to pass that Laman and Lemuel would not hearken unto their father, but took hold upon him that they might throw him also into the waters. 26. And Sirah, the daughter of Lehi, and the younger sister of Laman and Lemuel, forced her way onto the deck of the ship from the place where she was being held, and guarded by a son of Ishmael. And she took hold of the bosom of her father, and would not let him go. And she threatened to throw herself into the water if Laman and Lemuel did not let go of her father and her brother. 27. And Sirah was the wife of Barhanas, one of the sons of Ishmael, and she was exceedingly beautiful, insomuch that her husband loved her with all of his soul, and he was also a friend to Nephi. 28. And it came to pass that upon hearing the desperate pleas of his wife, Barhanas broke forth from the place where he was being held, and took hold of Laman and Lemuel, and was about to throw them into the depths of the ocean. 29. And the hearts of Laman and Lemuel were filled with fear, and they pleaded for their lives. But Nephi was bound, and could not stop Barhanas from doing to them what they had wanted to do unto him. Nevertheless, Sirah pleaded with her husband for the lives of her brothers, and Barhanas did listen to the pleas of his wife and released Laman and Lemuel. 30. And Sirah lifted her father off the deck of the ship and tended to his bruises, which were great due to the harsh treatment that he had received from Laman and Lemuel, and also because of his old age. 31. And Barhanas broke the bonds that held Nephi. And as soon as Nephi was released from his bonds, the compass once again began to work. And it came to pass that Nephi prayed that the Lord would forgive the actions of his brothers, and that they might reach the land of promise safely. 32. And it came to pass that the Lord had mercy upon the brothers of Nephi, but not because of their own righteousness, but because of his love of Nephi, and also that his words might be fulfilled which were promised to Lehi, that all of his children would inherit a land of promise. 33. And it came to pass that after many days and much suffering at sea because of the wickedness of Laman and Lemuel, they reached the promised land. 34. And now I, Mormon, cannot write the words to describe the exceeding joy that Lehi and his family felt when they reached the promised land. For it was a beautiful land, full of many plants, and there were many animals in the forest that were of great use to Lehi and those that were with him. 35. And it came to pass that they found gold and silver and all manner of precious stones and ores that were beneficial to them. 36. And there could not be found any other land upon the earth that could compare to the wondrous beauty and exceedingly abundant food, and raiment that was found in the land that the Lord had set aside for those who heeded him and obeyed his commandments. End of chapter 6.